So how many of you are awake? Wow, that's practically everyone. And how many of you will stay away? But that depends on me, no?
Yes.
Then why are you raising hands? So what we just made it happen was, it's called chaos. Right? Everybody was trying to speak at one thread, at the same time. Right? So the order was kind of taking a beating. Right? Now, I have 45 minutes, I believe, for talking, 15 minutes for question answer. Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Total 45?
Yes, sir.
Or total 1 hour?
1 hour.
Total 1 hour. Okay. So, if any question comes to your mind, what can you do?
Ask.
Ask. When? Then and there. At the end. Okay, so let's do it then and there. Okay, so what am I supposed to speak, first of all? Whatever you like. That is a good answer. Okay, so let's reverse the question. What do you want to listen? So far you are awake because everybody is trying to say something. So you guys are, how many of you are seniors and how many of you are juniors?
Seniors.
Okay, now the right question, right? How many of you are seniors? So everybody who is sitting here is largely junior, right?
Yes.
And they are untouchable. Because what I realized, all the seniors are sitting in two different sides. The juniors and seniors are not mixed. Yes, sir. No, sir.
Yes, sir.
You are juniors. Okay, nice. But then once again, you guys are sitting together, right? So now, one thing which I have established is that you guys are awake. Because I was told that I am going to take the post-lunch session, and that's a very bad way of saying that. Guys, generally, whosoever is speaking after lunch, you know, generally receives a very sleeping audience. Right? Oh, yeah. So I had 2-3 options, and when I asked the second member as well as the coordinator, and then what do you guys want me to talk about? He says, whatever you like. Okay, so then I asked them specific topics you have or the career journey. And the option was career journey, right? So you guys saw that IIT Delhi, right?
Yes, sir.
Now IIT Delhi I did thanks to Pepsi. Because otherwise I started my career as a graduate, as a data entry operator. So roughly 2 decades of experience. And every time when I'm visiting a campus like this, my success criteria is that if I get 3 or 4 questions which I cannot answer, right, which forces me to go back and look into something, either in Google or in some books or in some, you know, talk to my seniors, figure out the answer, or nowadays talk to the juniors and figure out the answer, you know, my day is made. Because I have traveled all the way from Mumbai, okay, and I was supposed to be here last to last year, I guess, but somehow last minute I had to cancel and promise that I'll be here. So I'm very, very happy to be here. Stayed in Pune in around 2000, so city has changed a lot. The only thing is that temperature is still good, so it's not very, very hot. So I think that's once again a good situation, right? Okay, so are there some volunteers, like the poor fellow is trying to make a lady sit comfortably, or everybody is going to listen to me? So far, your faculty members and the organizers thinking, why the hell we have got this guy here, who looks like more of a comedy show than actually he's going to talk something serious, right? So I think I don't have much to talk about. You know, I can wind up in 20, 25 minutes, not more than that. Okay, about 45 minutes. Unless you interact, you ask questions, you have something which, any specific topic if you want to listen. Before I start getting into this, myself, as I said, around 2 decades of experience with Procter & Gamble, PepsiCo and Accenture. And if you realize, they are 3 very different companies. The CPG, the food and beverage, which is also largely a part of the CPG, but the third one is a pure knowledge industry, right? Now, you'll be surprised, you'll be like kind of asking this question, say that after working this long into, let's say, Procter & Gamble and PepsiCo, what am I doing in an organization like Accenture? Because that's a pure, everybody knows Accenture?
Yes, sir.
Is it a good company? Good
yes, sir.
Okay, I would yes. Thank you. Made my day again. So I think, when I changed my job, both the times, right, and I've changed it only twice, both the times, the question which I had in my mind that, will I be able to do it again? Will I be able to do it? There has to be a significant reason for you to quit an organization like P&G, organization like PepsiCo, right? And I'm still surviving with Accenture, right? And have grown in the organization, have grown in, let's say, the portfolio, have helped in leading and growing the business. So I think overall, it's a very, 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 very rewarding process, right? Across, as I said, I started as a data entry operator, got confirmed into the organization, then grown to the next level, and that's all right. The one thing which has always worked for me is keeping yourself active. And what does it mean? Observing minor things and looking for the right reconciliation. When we started in the morning, we had Nimish and Nandini with me. So said, what is the plan? So we can go to the college. What will you do in the college? We'll wait, and when your turn comes, you wait the lecture, and then you can go back. Okay. Or otherwise, we can go to the blue shade. Correct?
Yes.
Yeah. Now, the blue shade, you have a very, long row or queue or, that trickle line will again times. So, we say, let's break the route. So, ultimately, you have to go to Bhagwan. You have to go to Bhagwan. Right? So, if you have to go to 2 feet or 20 feet, you have to go to Bhagwan.
Yes, sir.
So, we did that in 5 minutes. Instead of getting into that long queue. Barring the walking and going out back. Now there is one interesting situation was happening. Wo jo ganne ka rasma aate hain, uske dukaan wala tha banda, usko ganne chahiye the obviously, if he could produce the sugar cane juice. Us bande ne rule tod ke jahan se paddle chalne wale bande hote hain, wahan pe bhi gaadi park ki hui thi. And there are cop actually negotiating with him. Negotiating in the sense, he saying that, hata isko, pura traffic rok raha hai. And that guy is trying to buy sign. Arre bas kya, thoda sa 5 minute and all that. Ultimately, what happened? Any guess? The small tempo was full with all sugar cane. Us bande ne utha ke wahan pe jo rockies hota hai na, jo jisse paya move nahi karta, whatever you call, that thing laga diya usko. Kya hua? V lock, right? Uske baad wo tempo udhar khada ho gaya. Police wala chala gaya. Jab tak hum darshan karke laut gaye, wo tempo wahi khada tha. Did police wala do anything wrong? Yes, no?
No.
No.
No, sir.
Why he was asking him to remove? Because traffic was getting obstructed. When he put that thing on, he helped him or he actually
helped him.
That's the whole purpose he wanted, right? Yes. Now he had plenty of time to offload that and then get rid of. Ultimately, fine, getting award, 500 rupees. Or koi tarika to, so in a way, it is successful. Correct. So police wala did everything right. The guy did everything right. Ultimately, inconvenience is over. Now, दोनों ने सही किया, right? ये भी शायद मेरी वजह से किया हो, दोनों ने सही किया. Said okay, चल तू मेरा इसमें लगा दे, मैं तेरे को 100 रुपए ऊपर से दूँगा. Something like that. I'm just anticipating, assuming. I'm not saying उसने किया, but if you look at your life, situations like this come many times, where you have done everything right, but you're not getting the end objective. So you should be focused on end objective versus you should be focused on so first objective. इतनी लंबी यौन अलाउड नहीं. मुझे नीचे करके यौन करना पड़ेगा, ठीक है? Good. That's okay. Relax. Suppose he's very obedient, you say, yes, sir. Generally, I keep training you, so obviously your career responsibility is belongs to Accenture, right? And most of the time you will be surprised in organization like Accenture also the answer is yes, sir. Funny? No, yes, sir.
No,
not funny, right? Now, how many of you are into that kind of a zone? Because if you not realize there are a lot many people who are in that kind of zone wherein they want to go with the flow, right? Go with the flow type, you know, because difficult is to challenge the status quo. It is easier said than done. I was with Mr. Prakash here. I believe he has been here. I don't know how many of you know Prakash here, but he's an ex-CEO of a lot of many great companies. He has written the book like Winning Habits and Leadership Secrets, right? We have actually invited him to Accenture to speak to all the leads. And he is blessing us on 24th. So he's going to be there and talk it out. And when we were talking, the first thing which I was telling him that still the status quo challenging is the biggest problem. We don't challenge status quo, right? So, you talk about manual delivery, what do you want to listen? The first answer generally which I get is strategy. How many of you want to hear me talk about strategy? How many of you know the difference between strategy and planning? Okay, so the number of hands going up, you can realize, right? And everyone who raises their hand this much is, you understand, right? It's neither here nor there, right? The strategy is the most abused word, and poor Nirmish and Nandini, they were at the receiving end because for 2 to 3 hours we were talking practically on everything. They wouldn't have realized. Yeah, by the way, they got a selfie with Prakash here also, in addition to me. That's a good day for them, hopefully. I think the status quo challenging is the biggest thing. And that's what I have done throughout my life. I have not done anything else, right? By qualification, I'm a commerce graduate who has learned through many trainings, many certification programs, many educational opportunities. I have been the speaker in all the high, let's say, the talent management program. And generally, I learn through this kind of a session because when I get a chance to meet gentlemen like this who have been beaten the problems in their respective life, day is made, I think I pick up one or two things from that particular day and then move on. That was the work for me. Most likely, I think it's going to work for you also, and that's what I'm going to talk about today. Sounds good?
Yes, sir.
How many of you are disappointed? Anybody wants to leave the room? So I have your approval to talk about it?
Yes, sir.
Let's put up the deck then on here, because from now on I'll get to see. Oh, it's already there. Sorry. So the Twitter handle is there. I wanted to put my LinkedIn profile also. Feel free to link up. Facebook is a little selective. I have only 1,800 friends. So feel free if you want to make it 2,800 because I believe 800 folks are sitting here. So typically my friend book list can go richer by 2,000 by 700 straight away. And this is once again making a poor joke. So fearlessly never say die. That's the only thing which I can talk, this slide has been with me for a very long time. And that's what is all about. I believe, which direction I need to point out? Or which button I should press? Which button go? By the way, this is never new. Never works. I'm from a technology company. Technology never works when you want it to work. When we are in front of the client, when your super boss is there, you put that video on, and what you see is a screen full of mosquitoes. Yeah, that's the problem. Yes. There's a lot of problem now. Nothing is clear here, but I think on the two other screens, so whatever I'm going to talk about me, right? The easiest thing which you can do is try copying and then fail, right? What I am I'm saying here is whatever is going to happen in your life, the ownership, destiny, luck, bad luck, everything belongs to you, so have a plan of your own, right? Don't try to copy this. If you try to copy this, then you'll have to be as arrogant or as frank or as candid or as risk-taking like me, right? So if you want to pick up some things, most welcome, there's nothing wrong in it, but be sure that you understand that, and if you have any issues, feel free to, write to me if you want to, talk it out. I'm not able to entertain all the telephone calls, but my personal ID is your student coordinators, and they'll be able to help us. Left-hand side is my left hand side is my real boss, and the right hand side is my both individuals because of whom I have survived so far. Right? Because all of you, one day you'll get married and then you realize that happiness is not everything. Okay, why did you guys clap? How many of you are married? One. Two. You got married when you were 13. So, yeah, it's surprising. I mean, anyone and everyone who has got married, they know that what is the meaning of being married. But I think the best thing about getting married is that you get two great kids. My son is then doing his graduation in mass media communication. Daughter is still in 10th, so that's the good part of it. Wife is, we met in PNG together. From that time onwards, she wanted to start working. She only said that, she never started working. That means we are free to do whatever you want. And she's commanding me, so that's an easy experience. That's hopefully an easy work. Okay? The next one is all here, right? So, if you start, let's say, your career, if I may say so, average age in this room would be around 24? 22. And everyone would like to work, obviously. That's why we are studying here. Right? So 22 is, let's say, the life is of 80 odd years, right? 22 years is what you will, hopefully, 22, 24 years you will work, some of you will do master, so maybe in 25, 27 times, right? And then you will get into the work culture, right? Or the corporate. Generally, by every passing year, the average age of retirement is going down, but even let's say for the sake of safety, you guys will work for another 24, 25 years or 28 years, 55, if not 60, okay? And if that is the case, you have lived till 55. What is the most important thing for you to do?
Learning
to be happy. Anything else?
Money.
What else?
Achieve goals.
I think most important is to survive. Stay alive, right? That is possible only when you plan for it. Or no?
Yes, sir.
No? Okay. Who says no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, how many of you have done any kind of marathon, half marathon? Anyone? 1, 2, 3, 4. Around 10%. What do you need for a marathon?
Stamina.
Energy.
Right? Half marathon is 21 kilometers. Try completing it in 2.5 to 3 hours. In that range. You think everybody can do it? Why not? Maybe for 7 years, 7 kilometers is easy. If you break it down into 3, 7 kilometers is 7 kilometers for 3 hours, broadly. The first 7 kilometers most likely would be easy. Second and third will be also easy?
No.
Can you do it without building the stamina, without planning for it?
No.
You'll have to eat carbs, you'll have to run, you'll have to, make your, muscles, right? All that. And that's what it's saying, is prepare for it, right? Now the learning, money, the other things are the media means, right, what will happen. But I think some of the things which you'll go through is your ups and downs, your achievements, you getting married, you having kids, unfortunate demise of some friend, family, relatives, parents, and all that, right? And all those things will happen. I think if you're not planning for it to be fit, both physically and mentally, you will struggle big time. That is the first and foremost importance, right? I have seen so many great careers or great potentials in my life who have started very well, right? And there are some cricketers whom we were talking in the car, right? Who started very well, but they couldn't succeed, they couldn't sustain, they couldn't convert those great starts into the longer innings. We know about all great cricketers who have worked for 10, 15, 20 years and made mark for their themselves, their country, their respective states, and also made money in the process. I think the biggest thing is to survive. Biggest thing is to stay alert. Biggest thing is to stay fit, both physically and mentally, right? And the second one is becoming more difficult. First one is still easy, with despite all kind of possible junk food and everything, and a little bit of exercise, the second one will become very, very difficult because technology is changing the world big time. You know, when we started and when we started working, and thank God, you know, at times I feel, thank God, I'm jaldi paida ho gaya tech. In this kind of tough education and tough environment, it would have been even more difficult. We didn't have to worry about automation. We didn't have to worry about any kind of SAP JV. We didn't have to worry about all this cognitive computing or let's say the cloud, which is changing the world. We didn't have to worry about something called mobile. You know, I don't know what you guys get in that mobile, but yeah, you will get a lot because you know practically 60% of your time or 70% of time is getting stuck there. And where it is impacting you the most in your brain, you feel stressed. Most of you feel stressed because at times, every day morning, next day, without even realizing what actually is impacting. Lack of physical fitness, excess exposure to the technology is also creating some sort of imbalance and problems and impacting in your mental alerts, right? Earlier, you know, that those kind of all the bad drinks or good drinks were not available, right? Easily, right? There was some amount of social pressure, not anymore. This is also adding to the problem and then everybody's short of time, so everybody's trying to cut it short. And that's where I think it's becoming. Other thing is that you have so many friends, but interaction is going down. That's why you don't know if you're in trouble whom to speak to. Your boss, your friends, your seniors, or what all. So when you go through this kind of, let's say the lower things, you know, we don't know where to reach out to. The digitally, everybody is available, but can you reach out to someone and can you quickly connect and talk it out? You know, I think it becomes very, very difficult. What has worked for me is having a goal, right? I think it is important to know that what you can do versus what you cannot. Right? You are here, maybe you could not got into IIM Ahmedabad or something like that, from that kind of college. You wanted there and you could not make it. I think it's a good realization that what you can do versus what you cannot. And similarly in the other fields, right? What actually drives you versus what are your hobbies and passions? Because what will keep you going is your personal stuff. That's very, very important, right? If you don't know all that, then I think you will struggle. Rat race is not the solution. You know, all of you will be placed maybe in 6 months, 8 months, 12 months, or let's hope that all of you will be placed. But somebody will start with a better salary versus somebody will start with a lesser salary and that kind of. Somebody will get into a great A organization, somebody will not be able to make it into that great A organization. Maybe you want to get into that organization which you have chosen, which you wanted to, or maybe the other way around that. Excuse me, because of any reason you could not get in there. If that is the situation, then how do you deal with that? Right? And if you don't know, then what kind of platforms are there for you which you can bank upon and that's why talk about it, right? The important thing is what you want to do in your life, if you're not clear about it, you'll struggle, right? When I started my career, the first priority was to get into BNG. Right? And the reason was very, very simple. The organization is playing by rules. There are a lot of the organizations which don't play by rules. If you get stuck there, then you are dealing with the personalities, dealing with the political nuances of that organization versus, you know, having a very, very clear, systematic approach towards, you know, planning your career. If, let's say, I was not in PNG, you know, I couldn't have had a very, very open and candid discussion with your seniors or supervisors. And in that kind of situation, what do? You're stuck. You're carrying that stress or pressure within your own mind and you don't know how to let it go, right? I think those kind of situations is what we're talking about. Those needs to be there. I'll talk about importance of financial priorities also, but let's stay with me for a minute. What happens is that your success is visible to everyone or the failure is visible to everyone. What is not visible to others, which is very, very personal to you, is on the right-hand side. The skills which you will learn or add. And this way, someone who said about learning is bang on, right? If you are not learning anything today, you are wasting it. Whether you are learning something personally, you are learning something professionally, you know, maybe playing guitar, which will help you in de-stressing, which will maybe, you know, just simple running or some weight exercise versus, let's say, a completely new tool, something new, cool thing in your gadget. Whatever, but you need to learn something which you can back upon. Why I've made this laundry list is because of two reasons. The first and foremost is that you'll be hired to do a certain job, right? Now nobody will tell you how to learn new things, right? You pay, how many of you own a house versus how many of you are paying any EMI for that? An EMI for a house loan is a spending expenditure or an investment. As simple as that, right? Nobody will come and give you extra time from your let's say day-to-day job of that 9, 10, 12, 14, 16 hours, you know, to learn something new. That is an investment. You have to figure it out how to do it. In my case, when I started, I used to be a kind of good, I had a good command on that type of technologies. My boss was not that great. He used to do everything on paper. I started computerizing. I started, you know, putting those things in Excel, Lotus, and the related kind of stuff, thus by automating, and thus by saving time for him as well as me. As a result, he started coaching me more and more. Since I had started as a graduate, you know, I didn't know a lot of things which used to happen in the background. And now my boss wanted his time free, so he had to teach me. And he is actually, you know, I still have his number as God. You know, he taught me the basics of supply chain. What happens when? What happens then? What needs to be done? How it needs to be, it needs to be kind of categorized. And from that time onwards, you know, I have been adding skills after skills. You know, and trust me, strategy is a myth. So many times we kind of get lost in that I have studied so much and now they are asking me to do this. I keep hearing this from the graduates, especially from the management graduates. This is a reputed college. The guys who, you know, pay some 4-5 lakhs, complete their MBA, you know nothing worth MBA, right? And then they expect to do a strategy work. And what is the strategy work? Despite being in this position, I don't do strategy work more than 15%. My 85% time still goes in client management, day-to-day escalations, people management, you know, the business situation handling. At times, you know, taking my clients for dinner and things like that. Is it a bad job? Answer is no. I love doing it. When I'm with people, I just enjoy it. You know, I love singing. At times, we have sat together for 4 hours with my team members, you know, irrespective of the hierarchy, and we have been singing just like that, right? So I think the critical thing is that what is it which is going to get you to the next level? And in your kind of situation, even more important. The automation is going to sweep the industry, okay? That's bound to happen, right? So why you'll survive? Because of the differentiated knowledge which you'll have versus the other person. And I'm using the word survive, right? Because the transactional stuff for which we used to have, at times, you know, you realize that 6 laptops in a single machine, in a single room, locked and running on an auto mode, and it's happening. You know, there are companies who have claimed that in 3 years, the robots will start doing the surgery. Scary, sounds scary. Maybe the opportunity. The question was asked to my super duper boss in that if all this happens, what will happen to the human race? And he answered, say that in 1783, somebody said when the steam engine was invented, say that if this kind of things continue, human race will be wiped out. It hasn't happened for roughly 250 years. So far, hopefully it will not happen again. And human will start moving to the next level of job. But if you start moving to the next level of job, what you need to do is on the right hand side. Right? Now, I want you to cut down here, below here, right? From here below, you will see that, you know, learning all these things are pretty much, in fact, the first one should have been here somewhere beyond this thing, but these are very, very subject matter expertise, right? Very, very core to the domain. When you are managing network, you need to know what is access, you need to know what is office is, how it happens and all that. But all these things below here are, you know, you will read in your MBA colleges, but you don't know how to get them unless you do it, right? If you want to beat the competition in the game of cost, you need to figure out what are your cost levers and how will you get them out. And this is where it starts becoming painful and boring, as you can see it on your faces. Okay? Nobody wants to do it. But the guy who can understand the nuances of the business only will grow. Right? Now, it is quite okay to have a very, very specific target towards being a subject matter expert versus a general manager. Okay, a general manager, not in terms of designation, but, you know, trying to be the team lead kind of position and driving the business, helping them grow. Right? But I think the anyone who has this, in addition to this, has a better chances of, you know, let's say, growing within the corporate ladder, right? Or in that kind of structure, right? That's important. I think, why will you grow? I had said some certain things, you know, personal milestones are more rewarding. Nowadays, when I'm talking to my managers or the assistant managers, you know, they are reaching to a stage where they are earning enough and more money, and they feel like when they started from their management colleges, they wanted that money and that profile. Once it happens, then you don't know what to do. It's like getting married. Okay, you wanted to get married, happened. Or let's say you've been going along together for 4 years and then you got married. Okay, now what? Fight starts. Right? Why? No one knows. Because there's no purpose. Again, right? How do you know? What is the next? Right? I think that's critical. And what next defining is equally important, but what will keep you going, growing is your personal milestone. Maybe a bucket list, right? Somewhere in your own self that this is what thing I want to do and keep clicking. I love driving, I've driven 65,000 kilometers other than going and coming back from office. I've driven in between Siliguri and Bhutan, I've driven practically across Maharashtra, I've driven practically across India, thanks to Pepsi, and got paid for that, right? So this even better situation. But that gives me that kick. You know, you name the hotel in India, I would have most likely stayed. The most smallest of the gumtis, you know, that jahan pe chai milti hai, right? Because you have your warehouses in a kind of remote area, so how do you survive? You know, you pack two bananas and two apples and go there. Because you know that you'll get the food only when you get back your hotel, right? So that kind of situation, but that is important, right? I've already spoken about the second one. I still sing every weekend, okay? I get the time to sing when I'm driving back from my office to home, which is around anytime between 11:30 to 1 o'clock in the night, right? Because we work mostly in the European time zone. And I love singing. Okay, so at that point in time, nobody's there anyways, right? So nobody's listening. I'm the only one in my car, right? So you just play the music and you sing. That's the time only I get, but that gives me a lot of stress busting. Reach home, take shower, eat something, or clear your meals and go to sleep. But when you get the next day, if you have time to go to gym, great. Otherwise, you're more or less in a decent shape to, you know, mentally to start. Work-life balance. How many of you think you can manage your studies and life balance? That's quite a lot, actually. Much better than mine. Frankly speaking, I struggle. Because there's nothing called work-life versus personal life. That's got integrated. I just gave my cell phone to him for, you know, because otherwise if any phone comes in, it'll ring and disturb. If an email is sitting in your inbox, which needs immediate attention, you cannot relax. The accessibility or the technology has taken away your personal time. That's the reality. Whether you are on Saturday, you are on Sunday, you are at a hill station, you are in India or abroad, whatever, right? Work-life integration is the right thing, and I think you need to figure out something which can keep going for you. And here, I'll have a tip for you. You know, figure out a person whom you can talk to, preferably senior, preferably the guy who has been through that kind of situation, guy who can advise, guy whom you can open up to. And when I'm saying that, a guy means gender neutral, right? So male, female, dono chalega, right? So all the females, please don't take it otherwise, right? But you need a person when you can go and talk to. And trust me, it is not easy. You know, when you try talking about some personal problem situation, either the person is not listening or you're not comfortable in kind of giving the details. As a result, you will not get the solution or the opinion or a kind of recommendation or the options or dreams, right? And then you'll struggle with that, right? I think singing and all those kind of things kind of keep going for me. One thing which has worked every time, I have set my goals for 1 year, which is this year, with myself, and then 3 years. Mostly they are in and around learning. Mostly they are in and around something like, let's say, making a CD of my own by singing, and I sing decently well, okay. And. A video which I can keep with me, right? Some of the things like completing those marathons or the half marathons. So a mix of both personal and professional, because that needs to keep going on. If it is not happening, you will struggle. I think other things I have already spoken about, but one thing which is very, very important is if you want to grow, you will have to take the risk. And the risk is about making yourself redundant. Means a person who can do your job if you grow. Right? Easier said than done. Right? Nobody is going to give you a replacement. Boss, I can teach someone, but I need someone. Now, if you're expecting a boss to hire additional person so you can teach and that's why you'll become free, God bless you. Because that is extra cost to the system. That will not happen. So how do you make yourself redundant? People like me, there is someone who is willing to learn. You need to identify that within the system. And once again, that is an investment. Okay, a lot of time I'm making this, using this word. This has worked for me. Thank you, sir. This has worked for me. I think this will work for you. Because this is a give and take situation. A give and take situation is the only way to do this kind of thing, right? One thing which I definitely want to talk about is if you're working for good organization like I have worked, you'll get many offers. 20% increase, 30% increase, and you will be very, very tempted to jump. But staying in an organization for a longer time pays off. Okay? Indian military, what is the motivation for them to serve for the country? Anybody can guess? They put their life on somebody else's order. Why do they do that? They don't want... Sorry?
Because their family's future is safe.
That is one. Okay. I don't know if it is really safe. And sir is here, maybe sir can add more value to that. And I'm not deviating into that. But the point which I'm making is, you know, the people stay in the army for a pretty long time, right? Very long time, right? Earlier, the people used to work for government organizations and kind of, you know, stay with them. Maybe the safety was a feature. Maybe, I don't know. But if you are quitting, are you quitting for a 20% increase or a 30% increase? Are you taking your cost to the company in a total manner? Because there are organizations like us who spend almost $1 billion in training. Almost. Okay? There are organizations who just want you to work for that 14 hours at a stretch. You can't leave until this is completed. That's what generally bosses will say. And I have seen those things, those kind of situations maybe with my fellow colleagues, you know, who have worked for, or fellows, my friends who have worked for some different organizations. Indian organization and multinational both, right? It is all about being there at a place where you can learn and learn and learn. Because if at all you'll grow because of the additional skill set and not because of anything else. So choosing the right organization is very, very important. You can't just quit for money. These are some of the personal and professional beliefs, right? And why it is important is that when you want to let's say deliberate on yourself, when you want to do something on yourself, right? Have you played by rule or not? When you are answering to yourself, you should be able to. There are a lot of personal stuff, there are a lot of, professional stuff. I generally publish it to the team, right? This I have been doing for almost like last 10 to 15 years. Standing up in front of the team saying that this is how I am going to play the game. You have any point in time if you think that you know, I am deviating, you need to say that and say, Shikhar, that what you said, you are not doing that. One thing is, I'm not an easy boss to work. You know, rigor, discipline, hard work, and commitment is very, very important to me. I do that honestly, and I also demand that from the team. And by the way, I respect my most of the bosses for, you know, demanding more from me, because that's what forced me to do better, that's what forced me to learn. I'm never afraid of saying, I don't know and I need help. That, at times, you know, leaves very, very, some of the seniors very, very unflattered, right? They feel, what the hell is you're talking, and especially in India, you know, you're supposed to know everything. It is impossible, practically impossible. Even if when the juniors or let's say your fellow colleagues are saying that I don't know, you know, try to help. And that's the best thing, because if they say that I don't know and I need help, you can fix up the situation much more easily, right? I'm never afraid of, you know, being asserting early, saying that, boss, I screwed it up, come back and help me, right? Some of the things which I want to kind of quickly run through is, yeah. How many of you know something called term insurance? Okay, and at your age, if you want to take a term insurance policy, how much it will be for a crore per month? Yeah. 500-600 rupees. How many of you knew that? I'll tell you one situation. You know, a very young friend of mine, around 24, died in a road accident. As an organization, as a fellow colleague, we have helped them and helped the family. But after that, I just made it a point to go and talk to everyone in the team, say that you guys are young. Your parents have kind of, you know, given you the best possible education and they have got you here. It's your responsibility that you own it up, that if anything goes wrong to you, you know, they shouldn't be worried about what will happen to us. Do you think you owe that much back to your family as well?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, take it in a bigger perspective, right? You can take risk only when you have enough and more money. Okay, you can quit a job only if you have, without having another job, let's say if you're unhappy, only if you have enough money. Money is the ultimate reality in the life. If you have money, you can do whatever you want. You can spend it on leisure, you can spend it on education, you can spend it on your family, you can spend it on housing or whatever. But if you don't have money, what the hell you'll spend? The first and foremost priority is managing financial goals, getting to know, and there are once again professional help available here. So when you start early and when you start investing early, you know, you are much more prepared than some of us. And the tools and means are available, do that, you will be happy. Last but not the least is being uncomfortable, comfortable, right? You'll never have enough and more information. When you decided to take admission in this school, you had some amount of information was happening around it. Is this the best college? This is not the best college. You had to take some, do some calculation and take a calculated gut, calculated risk, and that's what most likely we keep doing, right? If it is IIM, yeah, I think easy, and something similar. But when you're off from that top five, then suddenly you realize that the options are many, and you get confusing. So you get confused in that, should I take this versus should I go for that? I think, you know, that will be the situation throughout your life. Some of the experience or the tenured resource are also sitting here. They must have gone through this kind of situation. Take your calculated risk and be very, very comfortable that you are uncomfortable. Because for sure, you will be uncomfortable rest of your life, and that's where the life is. You'll always be with people. There's always two sides of a story. If you are in the organization, you are in a school, you are in a college, you are with friends, you are with family, try to know the second side of the story, right? Because there's always a second side of the story. And when you do that, you know, you are much more better off. Don't try to please everyone. It will never happen. Very, very important. You know, close circle, take care of them. Understand what they are expecting. Deliver that. You'll be happy again. Finally, know what is expected out of you. Very, very important in case of the professional situations. Half of the time, you want to do something different versus what is expected out of you. What you're trying to do, your supervisor is not aligned. When the appraisal is happening, you realize, oh my God, I had to do something else, I have ended up doing something else, and we don't know what's happening. Even when you're struggling with, let's say, delivery or anything of the expected task, at least let the people know the kind of effort which has gone into the process. Because that at times becomes the game changer. You know, saying that everybody understands that yes, the guy has put in a lot of work, maybe there were dependencies enough and more. And that's why the end result has not happened. But failure is a part of life, right? So internal, external customer being happy is the most ideal situation, but it doesn't happen, nothing must worry about. And always keep the bigger picture in mind. What's right for yourself is the best situation. But if that is not the situation, then what do you need to do? I think you need to figure it out, right? The last slide, I think I'm more or less done with the talk which I wanted to give. Basically, you know, being genuine about expectation. This, once again, particular thing has been with me for a very long time, Michael Jordan and another poster which says that the ships are safe in the harbor, but that's not the place they are made for, right? The symbol that tortoise is doing, if the tortoise doesn't take out their neck, right, he can stay alive for 10 years because the skin outside is so thick, so strong, that will never be killed. He'll have to take his neck out only twice, when he wants to move forward or when he needs to eat something, right? So you will have to take your neck out, you'll have to do that, but don't be afraid of failure. At times, whatever success we define is good, right? But try feeling that success. You know, if you feel that success and then you feel good about it, go for it. But if it is not giving you that feeling, don't waste your time on it, right? Last but not the least, as I said, don't compare. Have your own goals. You will be much more happier than what you are today. That's what I had to cover. I think I'm still 10 minutes short of time, so.
Session.
Happy to take questions. There are no questions. We have a question.
Hello, sir.
Hi.
Sir, can I ask a related question?
Sorry?
Can I ask a related question?
Yeah.
Yesterday only I was kind of reading about the Accenture. They have opened a new agency, creative agency in New York. So, something related to creative agency for advertising, content advertising. So I want to ask that, is Accenture into content marketing for creating advertising agency for itself in India also, or is just for the clients that they have established in the New York?
So, we do everything what our clients want us to do, including the content management or this, let's say the marketing or digital marketing, right? but it's more working with the agencies in terms of shaping the plan and shaping the entire campaign about it. Exactly shooting and doing our execution, that's not what we do, but the targeted audience is what is the strategy, how to make it happen, what's going to be pitfalls, what are the advantages, all those things we definitely work with, and there are a lot many clients for whom we do that, out of India as well as elsewhere. Yes, it was very difficult, and that's why I said that the one of the criteria was that when I'm changing dramatically from the previous one, will I be able to survive? I think the answer lies in the long terms, in that if it is going to, how it's going to work, will I be able to make it happen, take some calculative risk, but the long term gains, and when I talk about long term gains, when you don't have the visibility beyond 3 years, but you know, you think like, or you take a guess, calculated guess, and that this is where you will be, you know, it becomes easier. The good thing was that all the three known names are very well known. You know, you are very, very sure about you, they won't be asking you to do anything wrong against the law of the land. Right? So that comfort is very, very important. Spend a lot of time in terms of understanding your people policies, how do you grow careers. You know, what is the mix of getting somebody from outside versus getting somebody internally. Get those basic questions answered and then go for it. It has worked for me very well. But yes, you're right. I was very, very uncomfortable both the times when I made that switch. Sorry, if somebody is saying, I could not hear. Yeah, I think the biggest difference is that when you're working for, let's say, P&G and PepsiCo, you're working for those organizations, right? So you are in a position of command and authority, you can take those decisions. When you move to an organization like Accenture, then you are working for your clients, right? So you have to prepare, you have to be much more prepared than what you were earlier, right? It's like spending your money versus spending somebody else's money. So the business case needs to be much more better. The entire alignment needs to come, you need to follow a formal approval process and make it happen. And thus, by forces a lot of back-end preparation before you go to the client and put it up in front of them. So you literally have your neck on the block, and also risk of losing out to competition. So that's the basic and the biggest difference.
Thank you, sir.
Sorry, which one is going first?
Sir, out of curiosity, I'm asking, how do you see the growth of operations in two sectors, the basic sector which actually contribute much to the GDP, the service sector as well as the manufacturing sector. So as per the projection, we all know that GDP is somewhere around close to 6.5 somewhere.
Yeah.
But it is projected that it reach up to 8 by 2020. So as per the prediction, it is more or less like manufacturing is going to play a major role. So how do you see the growth of these two sectors?
So if you go by the prediction, I think manufacturing sector should grow, and should grow dramatically, you know, to make that 8% happen, right? Even with the revised calculation. And all of us are banking on that and hoping for that, you know, that needs to happen. The indications are good. There's some systemic correction which needs to happen, and hopefully they will happen in time. You know, there are some things which are in the pipeline already. The IT or the service sector will continue to grow. Right, because the way the changes are coming through the technology, the manufacturing industry worldwide is not in a shape to make those things happen. So I think that they will rely more on the IT and the service sector. So this particular area will grow, but will grow by losing out cutting jobs on automation, but overall adding to the business. Right? So I think both the areas are slated to grow. They are very, very different. If you prepare for manufacturing sector, then I think let's a little bit more slog there versus slightly more white collar in the service sector. More polished maybe, and accordingly, you need to have qualifications much more better than the manufacturing sector. But bottom line is, to make that 8%, I think not only manufacturing and services, but every sector will have to grow. Thanks.
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
So, since you talked about automation, I just wanted to ask, in 1950s time, when Anderson Consulting was the first to say that the computers are not just for scientists, it will be used for accounting also. It was introduced. So about that, now Accenture, how it is looking for automation in the next era?
So the automation is happening at two, three stages, you know, the semi-automatic, fully automatic, and the cognitive. And the next era is, you know, literally on sitting on top of, let's say, multiple ERPs or multiple sectors, right? As we are doing the thing, the computers are learning how to do it, right? And the things are coming into action. Depending on the situation and the readiness of that business, and most importantly, the sponsorship coming in from the leadership of that particular organization, the automation will happen. 2 to 3 years down the line, the transactional stuff, at least in the services sector, will be history. You know, even the most guy who's like lagging at the last will also not be doing anything which is transactional in nature, because there will be nothing left, literally, right? I think the bigger challenges would be when the cognitive and other things come into play. Because all the command centers, the dashboarding, the decision-making stuff, that's where I think the technology will start impacting. But the computers have already started playing a role in your day-to-day life, especially with the mobile, right? Practically nothing which you cannot do on mobile these days, a thinkable future. Reaching to that driverless car and all that, the trial, I believe, in Singapore is going pretty successful. So the computer is going to play much, much more bigger role. I don't know actually what is left here in their day. But technologically, I think we'll be much more advanced than what we are today.
So one more question, a curious question. Since we're talking about automation in other industries, what about our home is like Accenture, in Accenture, while building the computers, while building the chips, how automation is used over there?
In Accenture itself,
will it start from home itself, or will it go to?
Yeah, it is happening. Yeah, so that's what I'm saying. Anyone who wants to understand what is happening in that area, more than happy to have a very specific talk about it, because you know that's the biggest focus. The automation you cannot avoid, because that's where the competition, that's where the game changing things are happening, and everybody is lapping up on that bandwagon, right? So when we are talking about the simple automation, it has already happened. I said like 2 to 3 years down the line, the last of the industry also would have done those kind of things. We are already into the next stage, and that's where the future is. It's happening as I speak, it's happening and it's impacting us positively.
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, listen. Right. Sir.
I cannot see you. Sorry.
Okay, all right. Sir, right now we are hearing like IT companies are majorly having their layoff, basically like Cisco. In like 1 month before came the news, like they are they have 5-7,000 people, IT professionals. Okay, so regarding to placement, as I'm saying, because like it's a concern matter for me. What this impact is on the Indian industries, like what the layoff is going on. So what will be the hiring season this time, the IT companies?
So I think when we hire anybody, when they're hiring someone, the hiring is happening basis of case study approach, right? You're looking for a person, how you are approaching the case study, how you are explaining the case study, right? What exactly the organizations like us, you know, some of the competition we're looking for, that how much you can adapt to the situation. Because you will automate certain things, you will, you know, the layoff is a reality of the business. Has been happening since ages, so don't worry about specifically off in a particular organization. I don't know what is the situation, what is the background, so I'm not the right person to comment upon any particular organization. They know the best. But layoff as a process, we should be worried about. And that's where I think, you know, you upgrading yourself to the next level, right, is the key. You know, the brain cells are like, they keep dying practically every minute, but the weakest die, right? So, you know, how much you are knowing what's happening in future, how much you are reading and upgrading yourself, are you investing enough and more, 1 foot in today versus 1 foot in tomorrow type? You know, as long as that is happening, you don't have to worry about. Don't try to solve the global hunger, you know, staying focused on your you as an individual and preparing yourself for future will definitely, you know, ensure you from all those kind of possible fluctuations, and I guess you'll be good at it. And that applies for practically the whole team. Yeah?
Sir,
so,
this was the last question of the session.
As we are looking for appreciating automation in every aspect, quality in our software industry, IT industry, or manufacturing, or you can say in the process industry. The thing is that India as a country witnessing the exponential growth in population, I must say human resource. So do you think that India can balance this increasing human resource plus automation? Because as we know, automation requires less workforce. So what do you think?
So, the new technology you can stop only to an extent. Okay, even if let's say you kind of, you know, let's say bans and that you cannot automate and things like that, which is non-sustainable, you cannot unnecessarily increase the job opportunity, right? It will be only that. So the solution, I think, lies in growing both job opportunities as well as, you know, the economy, right? If economy grows, hopefully the job opportunities will grow automatically. Stopping the technology, I think everybody has tried something or other disrupt and then the technology takes over. You know, that's how it's going to be. We could delay the technological advancement, and that has costed us almost 3 decades, right? When and without naming any particular, time period or any government, right? If the, let's say, IBM had stayed here, you know, how it had changed the country in terms of technology, we don't know. We stayed in our area of monotony, and that led us more or less to bankruptcy, right? You know, those 91, 92 kind of years, you know, that's what we are talking about. And when we opened up, this is what has happened, right? It's exploding growth. I don't see the worrisome situation for India in terms of job opportunities for educated people, at least for the next 5 to 8 years. Forget about 8%, even if we are growing at 6% or 6.5%, genuine 6.5%, we don't have to worry about the employing population. I think the fittest will survive, right? If you're studying without studying, right, if you're completing the degree but know nothing about, you know, and there are a lot many students who are doing it like that, you have a risk, but otherwise anyone who is genuinely ready, they don't need to worry about it, and they will grow. The only thing is, you should be able to put your neck out, and that this can be done differently, and this is what needs to be done. And people like me are more than many, you know, to listen to you, and, you know, start guiding you, saying that, yes, disruptor, get him here, and let's start moving forward. So I think focus on the studies, the basics, upgrading your skills, will be good enough. We don't have to worry about, at least in India, we don't have to worry about if we keep growing at 6.5%, and the decent governance stays in place. With irrespective of any party and all that. I'm not commenting on that. And I'm speaking here as a personal capacity. Whatever I said, I'm sure is not going there in any media or anywhere. Nobody's going to put it up in any social media. Sorry.
Hello, sir.
Yes, sir. Last one, I guess, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
So my question to you is, what role does supply chain management play in Accenture, a company which deals with IT services and client-based service consulting?
End-to-end.
I'm sorry?
End-to-end. Planning for people, planning for space, planning for IT, planning for clients, planning for demand, everything.
So supply chain takes care of all of that, is it?
Yes. So you have a different structure. You know, we operate, let's say, with three different, sector, you may call it. And then you have a shared services organization supporting the entire business, as we call it. But every industry or every organization or everybody is buying for their respective requirement. So Accenture is no different. You know, we have people supply chain, we have space supply chain, you know, whatever you want to call it. End of the day, everything needs to, you know, align to the bottom line and financials. So that's how it is here as well. Maybe slightly more advanced or slightly more behind, but that's where it is. Right on.
Thank you, sir. We learned life is surely a marathon, so prepare for it.
Beech raah mein dilbar bichad jaye kahi hum magar aur suni si lage tumhe jeevan ki ye dagar hum
to present memento to Mr. Shekhar Tiwari.